So run length encoding is another way of reducing file size, and we'll just take this example of my arrow picture from a previous video. So this, if you remember, is a 1-bit image. So the idea of 1-bit is that it can either be, each pixel can either be black or white, okay? With white representing a 1 and black representing a 0. So in other words, this first line, if we were to write it out here, would be 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1 in binary, okay? So we've got one byte of information there, okay? And 8 bits. So if this was converted into letters, so we would have white, black, white. Okay, so each letter being 1 byte, as we know, there's a binary representation of each letter. Okay, so let's just take this line in a bit more detail. We'll pop it over here. So this is the same line, white, black, white, and white. So this line, if it was encoded into a file, would equal 8 bytes. Okay, 8 bytes. In other words, 1 byte for each letter representation of where the graphic is. Okay, so we can use something called run length encoding to reduce this. Now, the way it works is we look at how many of each colour, in this case, is there, and then we assign a numbered value to it. So, for example, rather than writing out WWWW, so the 3 W's to start with, we would write 3 W. Okay. Then we've got a B next to symbolise the black part of the image. So we would write 1 B. And then we've got 4 W's to finish off just here. Okay. So we would write 4 W. So if we were then to tally all of this up in terms of how much space this would take up, we can count each byte, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So rather than taking up 8 bytes, we reduced it to 6 bytes, okay? And this is essentially how run length encoding works. It substitutes a sort of string of letters which are the same for a number signifying the amount of times that letter's there, and then the letter after it. Okay, so our line in this code would be 8 bytes if it wasn't run length encoded. Instead, it's 6 bytes. If we then kind of extrapolated this outwards for the whole image, we know we've got 8 rows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We know that if we use runtime encoding, each row will be 6 bytes, as we've worked out here. So we can say 8 times 6, which gives us 48 bytes. Okay. So if the entire image was run length encoded, that would be how big it is. If it wasn't run length encoded, we'd be looking at 8 times 8, which is 64 bytes. Okay, so you can see the difference in size there by run length encoding this one image.